歡迎大家提出問題嘅，或者你提問題嘅時候就講講你哋係邊間嘅傳媒嘅啦。
啊，好。Good morning, I'm Frank from the media. Our initiative of enhancing land supply strategy by means of reclamation outside Victoria Harbour and Rock Cavern development have started our consultancy in July 2011. And we have also started the public consultation stage one, or public engagement stage one, in early November 2011. We havegone through quite a number of activities that we have discussed with stakeholders and the public during the last 2 months. During these discussions, we know that in order to satisfy the objective of achieving public consensus on three issues, that is, whether reclamation outside Victoria Harbour or rock cavern development are feasible options,to increase land supply. And also, if these are the options, what are the selection criteria? In answering these questions, some of the stakeholders have told us that we had better let them know some possible reclamation sites to enhance the discussion on the selection criteria. Because of this, we have today announced some of the tentative and very preliminary reclamation sites for the public to discuss. We have still to go through another 2 months of public engagement. Our public engagement stage one will end in February, at the end of February. We are still trying to get public to discuss on the selection criteria andindeed, whether the two options, reclamation outside Victoria Harbour and rock cavern development, are feasible options for future land supply. Therefore, we wish to have some possible sites for the public to discuss during the next activities, such as the topical discussion on reclamation to be held this Saturday afternoon and other public forums.To be held during February. That is the objective of the media briefing today.
係咁將我講一講先啦嚇。咁我哋一陣咧就會預留足夠時間俾大家提問嘅。咁因為今日嘅簡報會完咗之後咧，我哋就唔會再接受個別嘅提問或者訪問嘅。啊，咁另外咧就話大家開始前咧就希望。為了容易啲控制嘅秩序啊，同俾多啲機會誒唔同朋友問問題咧，咁就請大家喺提問前咧就講一講自己嘅名同所屬機構啦，同埋每次唔好問超過兩條問題嘅。咁或者請阿唐生答問題嗰陣時，即係坐近啲個對麥嘅方便你哋大家收音嘅。
好。
係啦，咁邊位想開始問第一條問題？
Thanks, I'm Damon from Radio Hong Kong. Maybe Mr. Lee can also supplement the answers to these questions. I've got two of them, grouped questions. Firstly, can you just explain what are the restrictions that you faced in selecting these sites, the 25 sites? How did you actually come up with the 25 sites? And you mentioned that the public actually reflected views that the marineeffects on the environment also, and also the marine environment is their major concern. Then why did you still select a lot of sites in Tuen Mun, Long Khoo Tan and Sunny Bay? Those are the areas that are actually affected by the habitats of the dolphins. Why did you still come up with the sites? That's the first question. Secondly, I noticed you said you will shortlist about 10 sites next year for detailed feasibility studies.
Middle of this year.
But if you are going to select 10, how big will those 10 sites be? How many hectares would that actually be? And if you select, and if the public agree to all 25 sites, how big is 25 sites? And would you actually select all 25 if they all 25 of them agree, not just 10? Thank you.
Maybe I'll take on the second question first, and I'll ask Mr. Lee to answer the first question. Well, as I've mentioned earlier, we list out the 25 sites in order to enhance the discussion on the selection criteria, because stakeholders, some of them have told us that without some possible sites, it's difficult to discuss the criteria. In that case, our objective is still to select about 10 sites, but I said about because it depends on the public opinions. If they only wish us to, say, reclaim in less than 10, that may be our option. We do not have a calculation of the total land area that we can reclaim because we are still in the very early stage. We don't know what sites the public would readily accept. That's why we cannot tell you that what are the total area we are going to reclaim. It is still, I have to stress that we are still in the middle of public engagement stage one.
Do you have a target of how many?
In my earlier briefing on the background, we have illustrated that up to 2039, we possibly would need at least another 1,500 hectares of land, apart from those projects which are producing land under planning. So if we are talking about target, that may be a figure, but I have to stress that that figure was based on assumption of the current density of development, and also based on the current estimate of economic growth and population growth. I'll let Mr. Lee answer the first question.
First of all, that when we start up to try to sit close to the center.
Let me answer your first question. Is when we start to look for these sites, is we actually start from some 50-60 different locations. The whole idea is we want to start very comprehensively to look at the Hong Kong water from the very far east to the very far west to see where we could locate a spot that we can, you know, reclaim land. But having said that, even these 25 we said is a possible site doesn't mean that we were saying that they are very feasible sites. The as we mentioned earlier, is first of all, in this public engagement stage one, we want to ascertain whether the community accept the reclamation outside Hong Kong. That's number one. Number two, if this is accepted, what kind of selection criteria in terms of reclamation site? So to facilitate this discussion and to more. As quite a lot of the stakeholders have been, giving us feedback, is they need to have some sites so to assist the discussion. So we try to find and locate these 25 locations, which we find more possible. Not that they don't have a problem or area of concern. Some of these concerns are not insurmountable. They can be mitigated through different measures. Some could be a big issue. For example, you have to relocating different facility and things like that. So we know that some places there may be concern about the environment or a white dolphin, and we actually look at the dolphin appearance map. Some of the frequently appearing location, we try to avoid those. But some other area, the appearance of the white dolphin may be less than other places. So when we identify these 25 possible sites, we need to consider, and we try to be sincerely open mind to the
to the participant in the topical discussion to list out those area of concern that for to facilitate the discussion.
TVB 的鄭先生。
好，各位好，想請問翻兩個問題嘅。第一個就可唔可以都簡單講解一下嗰四類填海地點、人工島、蓮島嗰啲，其實會唔會初步睇，即係喺人工或者即已經改動嘅海岸線填海係即係最可行，或者個工程費用會唔會一般係最少，或者涉及嘅環境憂慮會唔會最少？可唔可以都簡介一下？第二就係話，其實你哋而家嘅目標係咪即係想揾一個係可以有1500公頃嘅填海地點？咁即係你哋揀嗰十個係會係十個市民最中意嘅地點，定係十個即係湊夠，即係會多過1500地點，即係嗰個準則係點？同埋咧都想聚焦咁講某啲例子，如果唔係大家市民都唔係好明白，就好似長洲南咁，咁佢就大過1500公頃嘅，咁係咪呢一個選址已經可以滿足到我哋將來嘅需要？咁個憂慮係點？
好多謝你的提問，或者我答了第二條先，李生可以補充一下第一條。我想大家要明白一樣嘢，我哋講緊1500公頃的需要咧，就係頭先我哋講嘅一種估計人口增長、經濟增長，同埋而家已經有計劃嘅供應嗰個相差，就大約係1500公頃。但係我哋講緊個1500公頃咧，係我哋一向都係想是用六種不同的供應方式去提供的，不是一定是全部是一定用填海去提供，但我們是理解到填海在以往的歷史呢，香港的發展呢是一個主要供應土地的來源，這樣解。所以呢，第一個想說的就是1500公頃不是一定全部要在填海。第二個想說的就是就算是拿1500公頃來說呢，不是說一定是單一一個地方有1500公頃就一定是足夠可以提供我們的需要。第一點就是重申翻1500公頃，我們的估計呢是用現家的密度來估計的。如果市民的需求高於密度是重要放寬的，居住環境是要更加是優質的，可能那1500公頃都不夠。第二點呢，就是因為它不同的選址其實有不同的困難，譬如長洲南，當然它在海中心，可能它比較一些近岸或者天然海岸對海洋的影響是小一點，但在另一方面呢，也都有不同的持份者或者公眾給我們的意見，就是你那個填海一定要交通配套或者其他配套呢是比較成熟，如果不是可能是非常之昂貴，或者將來是沒有那麼容易去發展的。那這一方面呢，我們也都要留意的，也都簡單地解答了剛才另外一位先生說為什麼我們有一些是近岸我們都要提出呢，因為其實就填海方面是不是只是一種意見，不是只是一定環境的意見，也都有人提出是你做那個填海要快一點有作用，換句話說呢，是那個交通啊或者其他基建的基礎的接駁呢是比較需要成熟，這個我們也都是要考慮的其中之一的。或者我給李先生答其他問題。
多謝你的意見。其實正正就是這 四類不同的填海方案呢，我們提出呢，就你剛才這位朋友就問我們哪種會好一點，其實這個就是我們想聽的，在市民大眾和持份者裡面聽到聽回的你們覺得哪種會是比較較為容易接受的。那當然呢，就是我們在個大原則方面呢都是要考慮那個經濟效益和實用性啦，那個對社會的影響啦，還有那個環境保護方面的啦，就是當然在一個人工島的方案呢，似乎看上來呢就在個對環境的影響是最小的。但是我們也看到呢，就將來你填了那個人工島呢，如果有人搬入去住呢，那他怎樣上工上學啊，他能不能夠自給自足啊，或者他出回來市區，或者去其他地方那個交通配套呢，都會是一個很重要的一環的。那這個也在我們在一個公眾參與現在聽回來的意見裡面呢，在我們那八個選址原則其中一個重要的一點來的。所以呢，即係我哋要去揀選嗰個填海地點嗰陣時咧，就唔能夠，亦
事實上都不會是單一地是看一個個別 的原因的。那這方面呢就是我們是想透過這25個的可能可以考慮的地點呢作為一個工具呢去幫助到呢即是市民和持份者呢去討論的時候呢更加能夠清晰看到那個選址原則去怎樣去運用而即是具體地呢就是得到一個有可以參考價值的建議的。
下一位
康年台中衛業想問一問翻咧，就係話都係跟進翻有關人工島嗰度啦。第一個問題想問就話，其實如果以一個即係頭先阿李生都提到話，即係如果要翻工翻學咧，喺人工島係好困難嘅。咁但係會唔會有另一個考慮，就係話呢一種嘅填海嘅方式，可唔可以係去做一啲，譬如可能係搬一啲厭惡設施啊，或者一啲唔係我哋填咗個島，唔係我哋住人嘅。咁呢一樣嘢喺土地供應方面係咪即係佢有佢嘅優點啦？咁另外就係話。即係其實而家你叫市民揀咧，咁其實會唔會即係究竟我哋係應該即係揀一個，即係究竟用咩準則，或者你哋去將來去揀食，究竟都係用一個將來用一個咩準則，係話我哋係揀一個最平、最可行啦，定係最環保，即係最唔影響嗰個海岸最少嘅咧？咁因為你其實如果用唔同嘅角度出發，又有唔同，即係覺得一時又覺得呢樣好啲，時又覺得嗰樣好啲。咁究竟其實係咪應該先定咗個準則？我哋應該係即係用咩準則去揀先咧？咁呢一方面，其實而家政府冇一個諗法，係究竟邊一樣嘢行先，係最快供應到土地行先啦，定係即係最平啊咁樣行先咧，定係最環保行先咧？唔該。
多謝你的提問。好像剛才我一開始這樣說，李生也有再提，其實我們的公眾諮詢現在就在第一階段的正中間而已。我們其實主要一個課題呢，就是都是其中一個我們的目標，在今次的第一階段的公眾諮詢呢，就是要講個選址嗰個準則係點樣？咁所以咧，我哋其實而家仲係聽緊意見嘅。我哋本身係未有一個立場咧，係嗰三樣頭先講嗰個可持續發展嘅指導原則咧，即係社會和諧效益啊，提高環境效益啊，同埋經濟效率同埋實用性呢三方面咧，邊樣係重要啲咧？我哋而家都聽緊公眾意見，或者可以咁講啦，我哋喺頭呢兩個月。跟公眾接觸其實在這三樣都有一些不同的意見的，我們是很希望呢再收多些意見，也都希望有這些選址拿出來大家給這些意見更加具體，因為也都有公眾意見，就是說就這樣說三個就是公眾指導原則呢，好易講，但亦都好難講邊一個重要啲。但如果有一啲選址拎出嚟呢，可能大家嘅意見就比得立體一啲啦。呢個就係我哋嘅諗法，就暫時我哋係未有一個意見係邊一樣係比較重要啲嘅。
人工島第一個問題，即
係
人工島
嗰個位置。第一個問題係人工島係咪可以擺厭惡性設施？冇錯，我哋頭先講或者去翻我哋而家覺得。去到2039年需要1500公頃，至少1500公頃的地的方面呢，我們的想緊是不只是用來住宅的，也都有配套啊，有各種的可能性的。那是人工島，當然你的意見呢，其實老實講也都有公眾提出過，人工島是可以將一些厭惡設施或者一些並非一定厭惡，可能是工業的，未必需要一住宅的，也都可以放在那裡，甚至是如果你話廣闊啲嘅，係可以將另外一啲現有嘅一啲設施係搬去人工島，然後騰出空地，呢啲全部嘅我哋都係可以考慮嘅，亦都係有公眾提出過，不過就未有暫時未有一個特別嘅方案。
下一位，米色嬲。
你好，嬲嘅專務行，想問一問就係、是。剛才都有講到，其實填海可能都是一個比較有效，即係獲得土地儲備的方法咧。咁但係即係嗰個居住的需求，你都講到可能是不只需要1500公頃的土地嘅。咁其實睇翻咧，即係即係要比較大啲嘅填海的選址，可能都是在離島那邊。其實會不會即係揀離島填海是會比較配合到香港即係嗰個發展咧？另外都想問翻就係沙田濾水廠那邊，就是即係話可以考慮就係搬咗入去之後就填埋。 隔離就有一個協同效應啦。咁其實即係會唔會呢一個模式係可以即係發展喺其他填海地區？即係會唔會揀咗個填海選址之後，就可能再睇下佢有冇隔離，會唔會有設施可以搬落岩洞，即係咁樣去配合咁樣釋出更多嘅土地咧？唔該。
係。我答咗第二個問題先。關於沙田濾水廠嗰度咧，因為沙田濾水廠喺我哋
污水廠
，因為喺沙田污水廠呢個選址嗰個地方咧，喺岩洞方面咧，亦都係比較覺得嗰個係可行啲，亦都係諗緊研究緊喺嗰度搬入去岩洞。咁又有呢一個咁嘅契機咧，我哋就亦都係諗喺附近，如果騰空咗嗰28公頃之後，可唔可以有協同效應咧？是在附近亦都填海去做呢樣嘢咧。你頭先講嗰個方法咧，唔係唔得，但係都係要睇下附近係有咩設施。我哋而家比較係行緊嘅咧，就係睇咗附近有咩設施係可以搬入岩洞咧，先至諗其他。而係沙田污水廠咧，係一個特別嘅例子嚟嘅啫。
嗯。